Vem magalenha rojão, traz a lenha pro fogão, vem fazer armação. Hoje é dia de sol, alegria de coió, é curtir o verão.
Vem magalenha rojão, traz a lenha pro fogão, vem fazer armação. Hoje é dia de sol, alegria de coió, é curtir o verão.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Now these are tonga being bought in for us to display in the store.
Wow, so beautiful.
Traditional Maori instruments.
How did you acquire
sound makers?
Them? Well, how did you acquire them?
Well, a local individual graciously lent me these to show me what's available. Some different carving styles.
Ooh. Did he carve them himself?
Have you ever made them?
I have. Kapa Haka festivals. The recent regional Kapa Haka festivals, I had these spun round. It creates a whirring sound. Mm. Quite atmospheric. I'd almost consider it kind of spooky. It's a spooky sound. These are obviously more instruments here.
What do they do?
These are bone, and by tapping them, different places, different textures of sound.
Beautiful.
And they're fantastic. Yeah. And these are obviously pipes or whistles.
Yeah. Can I have a look at this one in the middle here?
Certainly.
Put it in the middle. They're so light. Can I have a look at this one here?
Yeah, this is a double puttorino.
Oh wow, so...
Which stands for three voices.
Wow. So beautiful.
Okay, I'm ready.
I put the USB stick in your pocket.
Oh, thank you.
So this is a main puttorino, this one. And so have all these instruments come together?
They all arrived as a package.
Got some blues going on there, the Blues Brothers Rip.
It's lovely.
Here's the
Black
Pink Floyd.
Yep. That's one we started on.
Yeah, man. Yeah, so
you leave your story
the
about them already?
Yeah, no, that's the second.
No, he's going to come back and talk to me.
He's a through that part. And
he's
then
a carver.
Just loops around for about four times, I think, before it changes.
Beautiful instruments, and he's wishing to just work on
him
there. So
during
his body,
stuck or anything,
spoke to him, interested in having him catch this carver for me.
I'll let you talk to us.
Yeah,
so I found the voices after having a little play with these. What I found is that these two double puttorinos, they must have another name, I'm not sure, but I know that they derived from the original puttorino model. These are puttorino. I first thought that they were rihu, but because they've got one hole down there, one hole at the top and a pinhole down the other end, then it's pretty much the puttorino, and come out three voices. This one here's got a really sweet sound. It's very easy to get to once you've had a little play. It sounds the whale to hear myself. You can adjust the sound just by the amount of air, and the way you move the instrument around. Another key thing about these instruments too, Paul, is that you're putting your lips to the lips of the instrument. So it's about how gentle you blow. Like if you're doing CPR, you wouldn't blow a hard column of air into a person to revive them. And it's the same as these instruments, like human use. You treat them gently, and you'll cross blow very gently across the edge to find where the voice is. Most people that haven't blown these things will try until they pass out on the floor. So if they're out cold on the floor, they've probably done themselves injustice, and probably the instrument. So I've played that one, and I quite enjoy that one more than this one. These ones here, again, they take a bigger column of air to get the sound out. But there's always the challenge too, is working out the angles and the way to bring the light to the instrument itself.
Are there particular woods that are designed for them?
Most of these are, of course, will be made by the magic. Yeah. So you could get them, you can make them pine tree out if you really wanted to. But the harder the wood, the more solid the resonance. So the more solid the resonance, the further the sound will travel, if that makes sense. So I've had a little go at these two here. This is really nice in terms of its detail. And I think I've explained to you before that these patterns are like language in terms of how to read the sound and how to make sounds out of them. So without going too much into them, we'll leave that as is. We'll do the three spirit voices, or the spirit voices. And go to the other side. So you can kind of hear the different tones, it's slightly different. Need more time to really get the essence of these instruments, but I'm slowly getting them the more I handle them. Now that's a real sweet. There's no energy required out of that one. So those are the spirit voices that I've been able to procure from these two instruments. And I'm really interested because I've never played them before. And I just keep on having these crazy thoughts about getting to them and let them speak to me and me speak to them. One of the key things about these things, about these instruments is that we're always going to communicate. It's like smelling them like you would a horn. And you're bringing the essence of the wood, and even the maker who's put the blood, sweat and tears in there, bringing the essence of that man or that individual, because they can be made by a woman too. Up to you, inhaling it, drawing in the energy, and that would help to procure the sound out of these instruments as well. So that, like when you're home, your person, you bring the essence of that person into them. You do the same with these instruments as well. Don't you? So that's a little bit of a rundown on these. I'd like to get to meet the guy when I get a chance to, so that maybe we can work out how to better play these things. Clearly this guy knows what he's doing. And he's come from some wonderful background with deep knowledge, very, very deep knowledge. And these instruments, they keep on speaking to me.